show up the same, whether in or out the frame. Let Jesus mold me, I was going through some things. Thought it was a game, but I'm getting better in his name. It was never him, it was always me, I'm not the same. Yeah, I switched up, I couldn't keep up, I'm out the way. So let him expose me, that's another day that I give thanks. Hold on, play with me.
So is this the first, official episode of Alice, Let's Talk About It? You gotta forgive me for my candace right now. This is new to me. I'm in a whole new space because we getting it together. I can already tell these glasses, we're gonna have to do something about them, because I'm gonna need the ring light, baby, because I'm gonna need the light to shine upon me like it always do. But specifically this ring light right now, I don't like the reflection in my glasses, but God just got on to me that fast. We ain't gonna start off complaining. I'm so glad to be here. Not only am I glad to be here, I'm glad that you're here with me. I can't stop smiling. It's a genuine smile. I just ate a burrito, steak burrito at that. So let me pray real quick. Dear Father God, I pray and I ask that you just be with me right now. Make it so that it's none of me and all of you. Fill me up and use me as the vessel, Father God. Fill me up. Allow the Holy Spirit to move through me right now. Anything that needs to be conveyed to the audience that you would bless me with, I pray and I ask that you just allow it to just flow through me, Father God. Anything that the serpent God planned against me, planned against this podcast, planned against the people who are viewing this, I pray and I ask that you strike it down by the fire right now in Jesus' mighty name, Father God. I pray and I ask that you just allow my tongue to cling to the roof of my mouth when I get to rambling, because don't nobody got time for that. I'm going to try to keep this podcast as raw as possible. Right now, we don't got no mic. We don't got no, it's raw. Okay, I ain't come in. I really planned. I've been planning this podcast for weeks, really months, really years. Okay, this ain't no little she potty because everybody probably know it's really been. It's been in the forecast, but it's been a lot of rain in my forecast, so it's been blocking a lot of things. But God is good. I got a great call. While I was setting up, so that's even more confirmation that I'm doing exactly what I need to be doing, when I need to be doing it, how I need to be doing it. It's just God is good. But with that, I'm not your role model. I'm not your idol. I want to say that this podcast is Christian based, because that is what I am. I am a true believer. But with that, I'm telling you, ain't no true believer perfect. And that's what's been holding me back from even getting here and just talking. Because I felt as if I wasn't worthy. I felt as if I wasn't good enough. Because, you know, you see a lot of these people that just had the overnight changes. God just changed them like that. You know how Paul did, how God did Saul and changed him to Paul, like overnight. I wanted that overnight change so bad. I wanted that overnight change so bad. I just wanted him to just wash me clean. And don't get me wrong, he do. It's very authentic. I'm not on here saying that the people who get on here and portray that are capping. No, that is very well. He does it. Let me not just sit here and say that he didn't do it for me. It's some stuff that I'm not a fan of no more. It's a lot of things that I'm not a fan of no more, but it's a lot of things that I still struggle with. It's a lot of things I still struggle with, and they were the deeper rooted things, the things that I wanted him to change overnight. The other things I appreciated him, but like, God, let's get this out the way, because I know once you do, oh. But he said no. He said, stop. He told me to stop capping. As if I don't want to say perfect, because I knew that from the very beginning that I'll never be perfect, but quit trying to get on here and act as if I'm not still struggling with things. Y'all just got buzzed down like maybe 4 nights ago. And that's just me being completely honest. Four nights ago, about four times. Night until morning, okay? I'm not living all the way right. I'm a saint and a sinner still. But the good thing about God is grace. I got mercy upon my life just because he knew that I would be the one to get home here and tell y'all. I don't really got too much to hide. He knew I run my mouth when I got on here. And that's the main reason why I never would just set up the camera and film. Because I knew that I run my mouth, but I didn't know that's what he wanted me to do. Like I said, I wanted to come in here and have notes. I wanted this to be a very formatted podcast, but no, that's not me. That's not how I roll. It's just, that's just not in my fortune. But the reason being that he got me up here running my mouth is because I know that I'm getting better. I know that I am better because I'm better than I was yesterday. Like I said, I just got buzzed down four nights ago. Like four times, I can guarantee you it won't happen again until I'm married. During the second session, it's tears running down my eyes. He in the back, it's tears running down my eyes. The Holy Spirit in me is grieving. That was just even more confirmation. Like, damn, that's called conviction. There's a difference. I just was watching a Soft Life podcast. Shout out to them. It's a difference between conviction and condemnation. I was condemning myself. It's conviction, condemning. God, Jesus Christ didn't come down here to condemn no one. He came to save lives. So that's what the devil want to flip it on you and make it seem as if condemnation is what be going on when you don't be feeling right about a situation. When you feel like as if your soul is grieved, that's conviction. You're being convicted. Okay, that's God reprimanding you in this area to get right. Not condemnation. Condemnation, you want to heal. That's how I feel. That's what turned a lot of believers away from God, because they condemn themselves. When Jesus didn't even come down here to do that, he came down here to save us. So we have to stop condemning ourselves when Jesus didn't even come down here to do it. Okay? Gratitude. I'm hearing gratitude. We gotta be thankful. Thankful for everything. Thankful for the small things. Especially the small things. When you're going through a storm, praise God, always. And thing is, don't get comfortable in the storm. Don't get comfortable in the storm. It's not always going to be like that. Do y'all know when God sends showers upon the earth, it's because the earth be needing it? To water the grass, to water the seeds that have been planted, that's been picked up by a bird here and then carried over here and then dropped in, you know, stuff like that. What y'all think he be doing for us? He be watering us. God saying, just let it flow. Forgiveness. I don't know if y'all heard the song playing in the background. I hope not, because we ain't doing that copyright mess here. Anytime you hear me, oh, and that's another reason why I got on here starting this off, by letting you know that I'm not perfect, that I'm not your idol, that I am not. Don't look to me for anything. I'm telling you to look to God. Look to Jesus. Look at the Bible. Go read that. Because, baby, like, I still curse sometimes. I'm a rapper, okay? I'm a faith-based rapper. Christian rapper, if you will. But at the end of the day, I'm human, okay? And I can guarantee you that I live every day striving to be more like Christ. Some days I fall short, but at the end of them days, I can guarantee you I ask God to forgive me for my sins. And I can also guarantee you that everything I do, even if you think that it is wicked, it's all to glorify God. Because I know if I'm doing it this day, he's going to convict me of it. And we're going to move forward. And I'm going to correct myself. And I'm going to show y'all where I'm correcting myself. And we're going to get better. You are growing here with me. You are here to grow with me. Okay? In Ecclesiastics, that I always pull Ecclesiastics up, because that's a prime example of how to live your life. Like, it has to be balanced. I can never live like I'm holier than now, because, baby, I have my days. But the good thing, the great thing about Jesus Christ is he forgives us for our sins, but that don't mean take it for granted. Don't take his grace for granted. Don't take his mercy for granted. That's what you don't do. You don't use them up in that way. But he created you before your mama even knew what she was about. He knew you before you was in your mother's womb. Okay. So he know what areas to place grace on you. He know what areas to place mercy in you, on you. Cause he just know. Okay. But the thing that goes back into conviction, like, why are you doing these things? You know you ain't right. Is you feeling something? Is you feeling like it's not right? Okay, boom, get better, move forward. So I may slip, but I'm not going to fall. And I can guarantee you I'm not going to backslide. I'm not going back. I worked too hard to get here. Too hard to get here. And my biggest thing is I'm not that far ahead. I personally feel as if I'm not ahead at all. Just a tad. Because I got more sense now. Because I done got in that word. I done read the word. I know better now. But I don't know too much to where you can't catch up. And that'd be my biggest thing. You know, you can call me Allie Tubman. I'm not one of them people that like to be alone. Despite me always being alone, I really hate being alone. I want as many people around me as possible. I love having people around me. But it got to a point to where is them people around you, are they dragging you down? Are they keeping you where you at? You know, Harriet Tubman got to the point to where if she was waiting for her mama, dad, or brother, sister, if she was waiting for them, she wouldn't have left. She wouldn't have succeeded how she did if she would have waited. She had to get up and go by herself. She had to prove it to herself. And that'd be the biggest thing, you man. Well, I don't want to say she didn't have to prove it to herself. She had to trust and believe in God. And a lot of people say that they trust and believe in God, but their actions show otherwise. But do you blame them? Because, I mean, the God of this world, lowercase g, he is very convincing. He is very convincing. He'll have you feeling as if you and God like this, when God don't even know you. Just because you throw out a verse here or there, just because you say his name. That's even religious. Where is the relationship at? I can't go a day without talking about God, without talking to, forget talking about him. Talking to him. I can't go a day without talking to God. I can't. He's become a part of my routine. To the point to where I feel out of order. I feel out of conjunction. I don't feel right when I'm not talking to God. My biggest thing is I need to sit back and listen to what he got to say back to me. I do a whole lot of talking. I need to sit back and listen. Not gonna lie, so that's what somebody out there. We sit here and talk. The guy, we talk his head off. But when is the last time we just sat back and listened? Meditating. With God, that is, let me talk about yoga. Okay, now we're gonna save yoga for another show, because still, it's just episode one. I guess this is more so an introduction into the podcast. What is this podcast gonna be about? It's gonna be for believers. It is faith-based. It's about real life things, real life struggles. Like I said, I can't get on here and portray like I'm perfect. I'm gonna keep on saying we just got busted down 4 days ago. And I partially enjoyed it. That ain't right. Knowing who I am, knowing my worth, and not saying that he is not worthy, not saying it isn't. That comes down to me and my relationship with God, with Christ. Like, I'm cheating on my husband. I'm cheating on God. Because right now, at the end of the day, I'm single. Until I'm married, until I got a ring on my finger, I'm single. Until you form an oath in front of God, I'm single, and that's just what it is. So while I'm single, I just need to be, it ain't gonna always be right. It ain't gonna always sound right. But this is where I'm at with my relationship with God, okay? So just how, you know, Mary was a virgin and the Holy Spirit filled her with Jesus. I only need to be getting hit from the back by Jesus, Lord, forgive me if that was wrong.
Y'all, that was wrong. That was so wrong. I really played too much. Don't be like me. Be better than me.
But look, I only said that because while I paused for a minute, I was hearing marrying with an ing, not an n. Because, you know, marrying means like ain't nothing wrong there. Like, you can't get pregnant. That's marrying with an n. Baby, I am marrying ing. I only need to be getting knocked up by the Holy Spirit. That's how God talked to me, because, you know, that's the only way I'm going to understand it, coming from where I'm from. This podcast is going to be very relatable. I feel like I'm hearing it teachable. It's going to teach you some things, but Lord, I don't want to be a teacher. I don't want those responsibilities on me. I don't want that pressure on me. But who am I to tell God how to use me when I'm praying and say, Lord, make me your vessel? Y'all seen the video a couple YouTube videos back? It's the same channel. So you can see the little bit of growth. Before I was getting on here looking real gloomy, that's when God was whipping my ass. Hey, it's like donkey. He was telling me it's time to move. But I was tied down. Shout out to Tiffany Montgomery. Shout out to Reverend James Solomon. Shout out to Pastor Kevin Ewing. Them been my spiritual leaders at the moment. For the moment, I just came back from a conference. It was so good. I'm telling you, I was a sinner in that room getting beat down by the Holy Ghost. Loving it. Because I knew it. I'm here now. I went there to be disciplined. And that's it. If you're going to church, if you're attending any type of church and you don't feel some sort of conviction every time you go, find another church. If it's not based on the Bible, find another church. If it's not Holy Spirit led, find another church. You should be coming out of that church every time feeling as if, bro, this is something that I need to be working on. This is something that, because God, if God is in it, then it was something that you had been struggling with that entire week and God, all right, bet, boom, it's your lesson. Life is full of lessons. The blessings too, people only want to look at the blessings. No, you got to go through the lessons to get the blessings. Growing up, your daddy wasn't rewarding you. Your worldly daddy, your earth daddy, he wasn't just rewarding you for doing nothing. You don't get gifts for doing nothing. No, it's time to move. Okay? That's what this podcast is, episode 1. It's time to move. And you want to know what is, I should have took a picture. When I woke up this morning, I looked outside my window. It was a moving truck. It was a big old moving truck called All My Sons Moving Company. God, it's time to move. It's time to move. And that's the thing. God done pushed me into the water. That's the only way you're going to learn how to swim. I'm gonna struggle for a little bit. I'm gonna try to find my way for a little bit, but you're gonna see the crooked path is gonna get straight. And like I said, I'm so very thankful and I'm so very grateful that you here watching me grow and watching me progress. And although I don't wanna be a teacher, I pray and I ask the Lord to just allow me to be a good steward again over the audience, because I pray that you learn something as I'm talking. I pray that it's not just going in one ear and out the other. I'm praying that you understand me. And it's gotten to the point now to where the people around, like, discipleship, like, we all disciples. Like, you and your friend group, that's your crew, that's your clique. It gets to the point to where it's time to expand on a consistent basis. I was cool with my people. I was cool with the people around me. I was cool with helping poke them here, poke them there, and convicting them. Well, nah, I'm with convicting them. Because if God put in this on my heart to tell you, I'm going to get in trouble if I don't tell you. And even if I don't tell you, somebody else is. So somebody else gonna reap the blessing that God was trying to give me, and that's how it worked. God, do what I say and I'll bless you. Period. If God tell you to donate to this charity, donate to this charity. Even if you feel as if, well, I don't know what they did to that money. God know who he put the money in the hands of. He know what they gonna do. He know what their heart is. If God telling you to tithe to this specific church, tied to that specific church. Don't worry about what they do with money that they don't own you. If God tell you to give this a certain amount to this homeless person, give that certain amount. If he tell you to give them your last, give them your last. Do what he say. It's time to move. Just do what God say. He gonna move you. All he wants you to do is pack a bag. Don't worry about the destination. Don't worry about how you gonna get there. Just get up and go. And that's like stress-free. Living a life that is stress-free, baby, that is beautiful. That is wonderful. Not having to worry about anything. I love the fact that I can wake up and tell God, like, hey, I woke up feeling this type of way today. I want you to deal with today. I don't got, I take my hands off it. I ask you to place your hands on. I don't want to deal with today. I don't want to deal with the struggles and the troubles that I had yesterday. Father God, cleanse my palate. Cleanse my plate. Cleanse me by the blood of Jesus. In this podcast, you're going to learn how to use the blood of Jesus. Messing with me, you're going to learn how to use the blood of Jesus. Because I got every day. Father God, I plead the blood of Jesus over this, that, and other. Every day. It's the blood of Jesus. I use it every day. That's why I could mess up yesterday bad. Y'all, I feel like yesterday I realized that I hit a plateau in my life. I realized just because I knew I was supposed to be doing this podcast. I've been doing that, but yesterday it got to the point to where, bro, all this energy, all this extra energy that's turning into animosity that's being built up is just because I'm not putting my energy where it's supposed to be placed. I'm sitting here stagnant because I got a ball of energy just in me that be the Holy Spirit. And we're going to use the correct terms here. When I say God, I'm talking about Jesus. When I say God, I'm talking about Jesus. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And when I talk about God, I'm talking about Jesus. If I ever say anything about a spirit, it is the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, who dwells in us all. So God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Me, a believer, the believer that you see here watching, how I am, not perfect, still getting bust down 4 days ago, still not living all the way right, still cursing sometimes, believes in God, capital G, not the little God of this world, but big God, with Jesus Christ. Who's the Holy Spirit, okay? So don't get it twisted. So despite how things may seem, and this is most so, I know the biggest strife that I'm gonna have to deal with is gonna come from the religious spirits just because I don't do things in their way. I don't do things in a way that they may like it. But I know God uses the foolish things to, honestly, because I want to say belittle the people who feel that they're holier than that, but I know it's a word. I'm going to quote through the scripture probably in the description box, or I might even just put it right here because I'm not adding to the word. I'm not taking away the word. I'm just, that was my interpretation of it. God going to use me because he really wants the religious people, the religious folks to take him outside of the box that they done placed him in. Because then the box that they done placed him in got so many people who want to be believers, who really want to see what he here for, scared to come to him because of these religious spirits. It was the religious folks that decided to put Jesus on the cross. I digress. But with that, I'm not here to argue about my beliefs. I'm not here to convince you or convert you to believe in what I believe in. But I do take constructive criticism. Because like I said, I'm a new believer. And I do believe. And I do want to get better. I strive to get better. I seek God's face daily. I come to him in repentance and looking for his face daily. Okay? So with that, I know there's some things that I don't know about him. And if you a believer, you know. And if I'm saying something wrong, correct me, please. Like, I honor that. I know there's a scripture where it say, this is again my interpretation of a person that rebukes you, like that's love. But the person who mad at them, like getting rebuked, that's hateful. I know if you rebuke me, you love me, so baby, correct me, please. Just do it. Well, I pray for a great discernment of spirit. So If you come in at me with a spirit that is not of the Holy Spirit, then I'ma know. It's time to move. Thank you for watching me. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to drop them below. You can DM me. I'm on all platforms. Look, I love this name. God gave me this name. Because some of y'all may know me as Allie Dollar Dollar. I was in the studio and they told me that I can't shake Dollar Dollar. So if you want to call me Dollar Dollar, then I remain Dollar Dollar. But know that my life don't revolve around no Dollar Dollar. At the end of the day, I'm Alice Yvette. I almost threw my last name out there. But I stand tall in my name. I stand tall in my birthright. I stand tall in who I am. So if you're ever looking for me, you're going to find me on social media at Best Alice Yvette. God gave me that name when I was on my way back from the conference, because at first because I've been wanting to change it from Allie Dollar Dollar, but I was wanting to change it to only Alice Yvette. But I'm really big on words and the definitions of words, and only has a negative connotation to it. I ain't like it. So in replacement, I put at best. And at best, that is it was honorable. It sound like me. So find me on social media at best Alice Yvette. Y'all pray for that spirit of nervousness to get up off me. It's gonna come. I just gotta get comfortable in this new space and transcended space that I am in. God wanted me to tell you, you beautiful just the way you are. Don't change for nobody but yourself. And if it's for yourself, it's for God. So, y'all be safe.